Executive Council members of the GFA, Board Chair, National Sports Authority, Director General, National Sports Authority, members of the football community, members of the media, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Let me begin by first congratulating the President and the Executive Council members of the Ghana Football Association on your recent election by members of the football community to steer the affairs of football in the country for the next 4 years. The election of a new leadership for the GFA last October was a refreshing end to the FIFA and government-backed normalization process of Ghana football. Following the ignominy which hit the GFA and Ghana football in 2018. What befell the GFA, which took Ghana to its lowest ebb, was of great concern and worry to the government and people of Ghana. As a passionate football fan, just as many Ghanaians, I was truly worried about the state of our football and the uncertain future it faced. But thanks to the President, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, and the support of FIFA, we were able to set a clear path for the revival and restructuring of Ghana football, the result of which is why we are here this evening. The government of Ghana worked closely with FIFA throughout the one-year normalization process, all geared towards reviving Ghana football and producing a legal framework for the GFA to take Ghana football to the level we aspire to be. Ladies and gentlemen, from the football fraternity, I am as excited as you are this evening for obvious reasons. This gathering is not only heralding the return of organized league in the country after several months of break, it is also an opportunity for the GFA to make a strong case to all football stakeholders, including the government of Ghana and the corporate community, that the GFA has picked up the pieces and is ready to return with a bang. The absence of organized league in the country for nearly 2 years has had its dire socioeconomic consequences to everyone connected to the league. Many livelihoods, especially footballers, coaches, and vendors who sell at the various stadia on match days, depend largely on football for their survival. And I can only imagine the difficulties some of these people went through when their main source of livelihood was curtailed. I also believe personally that, but for the absence of the organized league, RTU would have been in the Premier League by now. Job creation is a priority for this government, and the government of Ghana will continue to encourage and support ventures which provide financial relief and economic opportunities for the people. Sport, particularly football, is one area which provides economic opportunities for the youth, both male and female. It is the reason the government of President Akufo-Addo has decided to invest in improving sports infrastructure in the country to develop our games and create more sporting opportunities for the youth. Through the Ministry of Youth and Sports and the Ministry of Inner Cities and Zongo Development, many modern mini stadia are being built across the country. Under the Zongo Development Fund, for example, we have mini stadia and Astros Turfs in places like Madina, New Fadama, Chidi, Wale Wale, and so on. And under the supervision of the Ministry of Youth and Sports, 10 sports infrastructure projects, these are really multi-complex sports complexes, are being built at Koforidua, Ho, Axim, Dunkwan, Fin, Nyinahin, Domainkro, Yendi, Navrongo, Wa, and the Azuma Nelson Sports Complex in Accra. I recently visited the Nyinahini Sports Complex, and it's virtually complete. In fact, it is 95% complete. And it is a very impressive edifice, and it is the same across all the 10 regions that we are talking about. In fact, I was telling the people of Nyinahini that after the Kumasi Sports Stadium, Nyinahini is the next best sports stadium in the Ashanti region. Ladies and gentlemen, these modern community parks and stadia the government is building across the country will provide our clubs and leagues the needed modern infrastructure for the development of sports and football in particular. The community pitches, which are located in the heart of some of the most famous football communities in the country, will give young people decent playing grounds to nurture their talents under better playing conditions for the country to produce more Baba Yares, Mohamed Polos, Abedi Peles, Suleiman Taris, Asamoah Gyans, Thomas Partey, Andrew Ayews, and so on. Throughout the world, government's greatest contribution to sports and football development is the provision of sports infrastructure to ease pressure on clubs and also make football better and easily accessible to fans. The government of President Akufo-Addo perfectly understands the principle, hence the president's unwavering commitment to deliver modern sports facilities across the country. Already, most of the league venues for both the Premier League and Division One are owned by government, and they are under the control of the National Sports Authority, or the MMDAs. Our commitment to improve sports infrastructure remains, and it means we will also have a look at these government-owned stadia or league centers to give them the required facelift to maintain the new standards we are setting. My brothers and sisters, as we all get ready to embrace the return of organized football in the country, I urge the new leadership of the GFA to ensure that the various league competitions are not bedeviled by the kind of developments which contributed in keeping people away from the leagues. Allegations of bribery, corruption, inadequate security at the stadium, and poor officiating by referees are some of the ills associated with our league. If the GFA and football is to win back the confidence and trust of the people, some of these negatives which derail the progress of the league should be curbed. It is refreshing and commendable to note that the GFA has taken steps towards repairing some of these defects of the league by organizing a series of workshops for key stakeholders, including an integrity seminar for referees. The success or otherwise of the league will largely depend on the integrity of referees. However, if all the allegations we have been hearing about referees are true, it means referees do not act or operate alone. They do so with key collaborators from the clubs. It is important for both the referees and their collaborators to desist from acts that will ruin the integrity of refereeing, as well as bring the beautiful game of football into disrepute. Ladies and gentlemen, one important thing both the GFA and the clubs should embrace in this era of digitization is the paperless system this government is championing. The paperless system should not only be synonymous with business or banking transactions, because its enormous benefits can extend to football clubs as well. As a real Tamale United fan, and also a fan of Tottenham Hotspur, I need to write to know how many matches and goals some of the club's greatest players like Glenn Hoddle and Gary Lineker, Jürgen Klinsmann, Robert Keane played and scored. Fans of Ghanaian clubs, especially the young ones, who are exposed to easy access to information from European clubs, should not struggle to access information from their local clubs, as well as buy club paraphernalia. So a paperless system should be the way for our clubs, because to go paperless is to digitize, and to digitize is to monetize. The paperless system the government introduced at the harbor, the DVLA, the passport office, and many other places has made business transactions easier, cheaper, reduced wastages, costs, fraud, and corruption, as well as maximized government revenue. In one particular place where we implemented the paperless system, revenue in that is in the government department went up by eight times the revenue increase, just because of digitization. In football, the problem of high cost of printing match tickets and corrupt practices such as under declaration of great proceeds from sale of match tickets, which affect clubs financially, will be a thing of the past if football clubs adopt the paperless system. Again, adopting the paperless system and going digital will greatly enhance the relationship between fans and their local football clubs, because digitization will bring fans closer to the clubs if they can easily access club information online and also buy paraphernalia and match tickets. This is very possible, and I encourage all football clubs to go for digitization to maximize revenue. Today, with mobile money, that's all you need. You can pay for your tickets and it will go directly to the football club's account. Kurt talked about the VAT that is being charged. I take it that these are my marching orders to also talk to the Minister of Finance, so that when the next budget is being done, we can remember our football clubs and make sure we do this. Ladies and gentlemen, last week at the President's encounter with the media, he charged the GFA to work hard to ensure the Black Stars end their African Cup of Nations trophy drought at the next tournament in Cameroon in 2021. It will be exactly 40 years since the Black Stars won the trophy in Libya in 1981. And I want to reiterate the President's call for the Black Stars to bring back the glory days. Whatever we do with our league and our junior national teams, the ultimate objective for Ghana football is the success of the Black Stars. We want the Black Stars to be successful, and we want to win the African Cup of Nations again. We don't want to win just one African Cup and fold up again. We want to win and dominate African football for years, as we did some times back. However, we can only do that with an efficient youth development program and a strong competitive league which will produce the best players for the country. Otherwise, government's huge investment in the Black Stars and other national teams will not be realized. I am, however, very, very happy with what I have heard from the president of the GFA today. It is clear that there is out-of-the-box thinking that is being brought to bear by the president and the executive members of the GFA, and I want to applaud them and to continue with all of this new thinking that they have, the coaching and the attachments and all of that. I think it's fantastic, and you should continue to do this. The responsibility to achieve our goals is a collective one. We should not only be left on the shoulders of the new leadership of the GFA. Every football stakeholder has a role to play, especially the football clubs. And I wish all the clubs the best in the upcoming football season, and especially Real Tamale United. I thank you all for your attention.